Gauri Manohari is a 23rd Melakarta, a very good raga with a lot of scope for expansion. You can often see artists even taking it up as a main piece, rendering ragam tanam pallavis in it. It has a lot of aesthetic possibilities. Typical Carnatic gamakams can be rendered nicely in this raga. Sarigama.
Sarigama.
Sarigaya.
Sarigama. Ma.
Padanifam.
Padanisa.
Sanidap. Sanidapam.
Sanidapa.
Magarisa.
Magarisa.
So this double ga that I rendered now. So all this will be used in Gowrimanohari. But when you are rendering that without the double ga, try and finish in ni. If you simply do that, it will sound more like Bhairavi. Okay? In Karagara Priya, you should try to avoid that phrase altogether. Always better for Karagara Priya. Clear distinction there. Will be neither like Karagara Priya nor like Bhairavi kind of thing. But in Gowrimanohari, you can use these other kind of Gandharams also, depending on the context. Better to come off to ni in that kind of situation. So, if you saw, ri is plain, oscillated, even that mild oscillation is allowed. Ma will generally be plain in many cases. Ma sometimes. When you are doing sarigamapa, sarigamma better. Sarigamma padayap. When ma is the first note, in that phrase, then you can have it with that oscillation. When you are going higher. Ni is generally oscillated. When you sing it fast, it will be rendered almost on sa. That rini dapa is a nice phrase in this raga once in a while.
Dine is a riga magarifani. Nis a riga rifani. Gadifani. Gadini. Dini. 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 Dini.
That beautiful phrase with that plain ma there will be very nice. Some of the key phrases. So let's look at the composition. Vishati Vishati in Gowrimanohari Mishra Chapu of Venkatakavi. Venkatakavi has composed at least one other kriti in this raga. Paramo Param